Right, this is fourth grade, module 5, lesson 3. And in this lesson, students are going to be taking just fractions, and they're going to be representing them not only as a decomposition of unit fractions, but they're also going to be taking that repeated addition concept and turning it into multiplication. Let's get started on this.
So here it says, decompose each fraction modeled by the tape diagram as a sum of unit fractions. So there's that unit fraction thing. And then turn it into multiplication. And so our first example here, we have a fraction that's clearly 2/3, right? Because the whole thing is one whole. It's been chopped up into 3 equal size pieces. There's our 2. So our sum of unit fractions is 1/3 plus 1/3. And since we have 2 of them, that could be 2 times 1/3. All right, so that's our kind of our lead in. So let's take a look at what we've got here. So this is 3/4, and we know it's 3/4 because our whole has been cut into 4 pieces. 3 of them are shaded. So as a sum of unit fractions, that's going to be 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4. And just like if you were to say, you know, 4 plus 4 plus 4 is the same thing as 3 times 4, here, you've got 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4, so this is the same thing as 3 times 1/4, and there we go. More of the same, only this time we can see we have 4 pieces shaded in, and it takes 3 pieces to make one whole, so our fraction is 4/3. And if we want to write it as a sum of 2 products, so there's a lot of ways we could do it, but I'm going to say, okay, well, right here is 3/3 plus we have 1/3, right? So I'm going to take this 4/3 and I'm going to move it down here, right here. And I'm going to say, well, that is, let's see, I could think of it as 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3. That's this first part, plus this last third, which is this guy over here. Now this, by the way, is not expected as part of Eureka math, but I want to kind of make it obvious here. And so that makes this 3 times 1/3, plus, and this is 1 times 1/3. So there's one way to list it as a sum of 2 products. Now, why are we doing that? Well, we're doing that because down the road, we want students to be able to see this as one whole, and this is 1/3, so that we want students to see that eventually this is 1 1/3, kind of guiding our students towards a standard algorithm for turning improper fractions into mixed numbers. But really, it's also nice because this leads our students towards the idea of multiplying fractions, which they will do in 5th grade. Now, there is no magic for what the answer could be. I mean, really, if you think about it, we could say, well, 4/3 is 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3, and we could put our parentheses right here, and we can change this to 2 times 1/3 plus 2 times 1/3. I suppose there's no rule right now at this point for how we use a sum of 2 products, and so there's another option. Now here we're just kind of taking away some of the scaffolding. We're supposed to draw the tape diagram and then record a couple of things. So first let's draw the tape diagram. So in this case, 3/5. Here's our one whole, 5 pieces, and we're going to shade in 3 of those 5 pieces. Now, if we're going to record it as a, let's see, and record the given fractions, whoa, I'm getting yelled at, as a decomposition into unit fractions. So, okay, so that means 3/5 is going to be 1/5 plus 1/5 plus 1/5. And then if we want to record that as a multiplication, we'd say, oh, well, that's 3 times 1/5. So moving to 8/5, a little bit more tricky because our numerator, 8 is larger than our denominator, 5. But basically that 8 means we have 8 pieces. So I'm going to draw 8 pieces, and I'm going to cut it into 4 pieces. Then each one of those I'm going to cut in half. So now we have 8 pieces. And the fact that the denominator is a 5 tells us that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These 5 pieces right here is one whole. So that is one whole right there. And then we still have these 3 pieces remaining over here, and I kind of overlapped a little bit. There, we still have those 3 remaining pieces. So first off, what is our sum of unit fractions? So 8/5 is going to be 1/5 plus 1/5 plus 1/5 plus 1/5 plus 1/5 plus 1/5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have 1/5 8 times. Now we're going to record it as a multiplication sentence. And so that's going to be 8 times 1/5. Now, parents and teachers, if you want, with your high-flying students, or just to enrich your students' experience, you could say, well, 8/5 is, you know, you could think of it as these 5/5 put together is 5/5 plus the remaining 3/5. That'd be these 3/5 over here. And that leads us to 1 plus 3/5, which is 1 3/5. It's kind of a foreshadowing of turning a mixed, an improper fraction into a mixed. By the way, there's nothing improper about this fraction, as in wrong with it. Improper makes it sound like it's wrong. And really, improper just means the numerator is bigger than the denominator. And that wraps up 4th grade Module 5, Lesson 3, where we're taking fractions, representing it as a multiplication problem. For example, 3/8 is 3 times 1/8.